Hi, I'm Dr. Steve Gleddy, a scientist here at Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada. Science helps farmers to succeed, and a big part of our success is the development of novel products. Research also helps the farmer's bottom line, while ensuring Canadians have a safe and nutritious supply of food. For over 100 years, Canadian scientists have been working at developing crops adapted to the harsh Canadian environment. An example is wheat, which helped develop the Canadian prairies to agriculture and earned Canada the reputation of being the breadbasket of the world. A more recent example is soybeans. Soybeans have earned their popularity with the high-protein, high-oil beans finding use as food for human consumption, animal rations, as well as many industrial products. As you can see, here's a soybean plant. Soy is a vine, much like the pea plant. It can grow to about 130 centimeters. It has trifoliate leaves. And the seed pods have between 2 and 4 seeds. Soy fields were almost non-existent in Canada 25 years ago, and now soy is a bulging, lucrative market for farmers in eastern Canada thanks to Canadian researchers. Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada's plant breeders were key players because they developed plants that could grow in Canada's unique growing conditions. Although Canada is a relatively small player in the international soybean trade, we do export a considerable amount. Up to 40% of our crop is produced and exported as high-value, high-quality, food-grade soybeans. These soybeans are exported to Asia. They're primarily used in specialized food products in Asia, such as miso, natto, tempeh, and edamame. Whereas in North America, in the grocery store, you'd be more familiar with products such as tofu, soy milk, veggie burgers, and the more conventional food products made from soybean. The industrial potential of soybeans has long held appeal. For example, Henry Ford, the founder of the Ford Motor Company, was an early proponent of using soybeans as an industrial source of plastics, fibers, and paints. Today, the dream is alive, and soybeans are now used in car parts such as foam for your seat. The recent concerns over the environmental implications of crude oil-derived products has led to a renewed interest in a diesel fuel substitute. Soybeans are especially suited for oil-based hydraulic fluids in logging equipment. Should there be an equipment leak, the environmental impact is much less than that of crude oil-based products. Although soy-based textiles have been around for decades, in fact, Henry Ford made himself a suit out of soybean protein in the 1940s, recent advances in soy protein processing have facilitated the production of high-end soy yarn, such as this. These offer a nice natural alternative. My colleagues and I are proud to be part of a large international scientific collaboration with industry and scientists worldwide that helps advance agricultural research. And I hope you've learned something about soy research in Canada today.